spring of 2012. And Verdi Powers, the associate conference minister of the Illinois Conference of the United Church of Christ, serving Chicago Metropolitan Association, called Pilgrim Church and asked if we would host the spring meeting. And we, being Pilgrim Church, said yes. And I asked Wilbert, because the choir had sung this piece several months before and did it so beautifully. And so I was so uplifted by it, I asked if you would do it again for this service, because I was going to be preaching, not to Pilgrim, but to the Chicago Metropolitan Association. And I remember the Sunday before, I said to Pilgrim, "So you know, I can preach to you because I know you and I love you. And I know you love me back. So if you can be here for that meeting, that gathering, I'd really like you to be here so that I can feel your support when I'm preaching to the wider church. And I know a lot of people in the wider church, but I don't know them all, right?" And as I recall, many of you were here on a Saturday morning, and I'm pretty sure that Bruce Cox came and sat right here in the front seat so I could see somebody who loves me. This is a place filled with love. You have given me that love. So good that today the text is this one. You know I love the Gospel of Mark. I love them all. I particularly love the Gospel of Mark because he cuts to the chase. We don't have all the extra stuff. He cuts to the chase. So just in the last few Sundays, in the Gospel of Mark, we've had Jesus calling the disciples, and they say, "Yes, here I am." And last week, we had Jesus teaching with authority, and they saw that. And this week, again, we have this way that Mark approaches things. We start with a story, we go to something else, and we come back. We have several stories here, right? Simon's mother is ill, and Jesus goes in. And what does he do to heal her? He takes her by the hand. She's not an outcast, even though she's sick. He takes her by the hand, and she stands up and does what she does. Yeah, she does what she does. And Jesus goes around healing people. The throngs are at the door. How does he heal those people? He looks them in the eye. He says, "Carol, I see you. I see you and I love you." That's how he did it. He made people human. He made them alive. He made them important. That's what we do here. We make people important. We make them someone to be seen, someone to journey with. Another piece that we hear today in this gospel that's an important piece is this piece about secrecy. The Gospel of Mark is filled with that. Last week, Jesus silenced the demon, and again he says, silence to the demon. The demon won't talk. And later on he says, silence to the disciples, don't talk. And sometimes people hear that as it's a secret. Something only the good people know. Only the folks from our club. But that isn't what the Gospel of Mark is about. Here it's more like the Epistle of James, you know, where James says, faith without works doesn't cut it. I'm pretty sure that's not exactly how James says it, but you get the point, right? Don't go gossiping about what I'm doing. Do the work. Get on the journey with me and come along. We got work to do, you and me. And we're gonna do that work, each of us. Not just one of us standing up here who gets to talk whenever she wants, but you too. You've got that work to do, and you do it so well. So well. Maybe it's singing a song. Maybe it's teaching somebody about something important, like what's on their heart. Maybe it's sitting next to somebody who ain't feeling so good today. We got work to do. It may be true that I'm retiring, but we got work to do. The work doesn't stop. We will keep doing the work, because that's what the one that we follow wants. That's what the one that we follow needs, right? He needs each of us doing this work. Each of us. Next week, Gloria Cox will lead worship, and she will take you to the mountaintop with Jesus and Peter and James and John. And we, because we get to read the story over and over and over and over again, might get it, might understand what it is going on. Peter and James and John, not so much. They're not going to get it, right? They're going to want to hold Jesus where he is at the top of the mountain. They're going to want to build a booth so that he can't go anywhere, so they've captured him. And yet, they're going to have to come down from the top of the mountain and do the work. We always have the work to do. Today, and tomorrow, and the next day. And I know that you all are ready to keep doing the work. How do I know that? You told me. You told me yesterday. You said, Sally, we might miss you, but boy, we are ready. We will keep opening our doors. We will keep showing up. We will keep standing up. We will keep speaking up. We will do the work. Yes, you can count on that.
Yes.
And yesterday, I said that the one legacy I want is that you know deep in your heart how beloved you are as Pilgrim Church. And it isn't just in your head. God has written it on your heart, and you will carry it with you forever. Whether you have officially stepped forward and become a member of Pilgrim Church, or whether people look around and they go, what, you're not a member? Or you just stepped into the sanctuary for the first time, you are part of this faith community. This faith community that has been called to do God's work here and now, because in this gospel, the realm of God is here. And it's here because you are willing to do what it takes. You won't be quiet. You won't sit down. You won't be silent. Amen is right. I heard an amen over there, and I've been hearing amen since I started preaching over here. This is Black Church this month. Come on.
Amen.
Well, that's a little better.
Say it, preacher.
Preach it, sister.
That's right.
So I get to be carried today in this service because this choir is singing such beautiful music. And we have these beautiful musicians here who are holding us up. And the woman whose hand I'm holding, who was trying not to see me at all today, curated this service and every service this month. And I use that word intentionally. The amount of thought and love and care that went into this. Amen is right. Amen is right. Amen. So, yesterday, when we had the food, next door, food's always good. A couple people, actually more than one person, came up to me and said, "So you're not going to say goodbye tomorrow?" And I didn't quite get that. But then I realized, last week, I reminded you what was going to happen today. Last week, I said that I walk into this sanctuary today as your pastor. And when I leave the sanctuary today, I will no longer be your pastor. A change that hurts my heart, and I know it hurts other people's hearts, and we will survive it, and we will continue the work.
Yes.
What I was not saying was that I won't be back there at the end of the service, like I'm always back there at the end of the service, right? Jim and I, and Mary Altenbaumer, and Gloria Cox will be back there at the end of the service. And then if we're still standing when y'all have left the sanctuary, we'll be over there having some food, at least for a little while. So, yeah. It has been my honor, my privilege to stand with you, to walk with you, to cajole you, to be cajoled, knowing that in this place we get it, that the realm of God is here.
Oh, yes.
Because each of you is here doing the work.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.